This is a magnificent frigate bird. The seabird has a mighty wingspan of about 2.4 meters. It can stay in the air for several days and nights, and may even sleep on the wing. But what is most impressive is the fact that males can inflate their chests and play drum solos on it. The result is a crazy, jazzy mix of drums and clicks. Which leads us to the question, which frequency do the females like the most? Magnificent frigatebirds are huge, gangly seabirds found around the warm waters of the southern U.S. and all the way down to Brazil. They often nest in large colonies, building nests out of sticks and shrubs. As true masters of the coastal waters, magnificent frigatebirds soar effortlessly on their 2.4 meter long wings as they search for fish. There's just one problem. The birds can't land on sea. In fact, strangely for seabirds, they don't have waterproof feathers. These airborne giants would actually drown if they ever fell into the sea. They feed on fish without wetting their feet and therefore spend long hours aloft. They can stay in the air for several days and nights and may even sleep on the wing. In this manner, they traverse huge expanses of sea. Researchers found that the birds remained in the air day and night, with the shortest trip lasting 8 hours and the longest almost 4 days. They reached altitudes as high as 2,300 meters and came close to the sea only once every 7 hours on average in search of food. They are amazingly agile flyers, but for all their elegance, they're not above piracy, trying to steal an easy meal from each other. Competition is tough, not only for food. Males also try to steal the hearts of females in a curious manner. When it comes to mating, the jet black males perch in groups of up to 30 at a time. Displaying side by side, each male inflates the skin of his bright red throat pouch, which swells into an immense, elongated heart shape below his long, slender beak. Then the male rattles his bill, drumming it briskly against the huge red balloon of his pouch. As they drum, the males also wave their heads, quiver their wings, and screech a bit. And then they really step it up when a female glides overhead. The females survey the males from above, picking their partners whilst on the wing. Ecologists who studied male birds' courtship moves concluded that the sound effects significantly predict mating success. Males that drum at lower frequencies, thanks to larger gular sacs, and in quicker, more constant cadences, appealed more to females, which may perceive them as more experienced or vigorous, the study says. In short, the larger the sac, the more attractive a male seems to be. If the courtship was successful, both parents will spend time in the nest, feeding their hatchling. After 10 weeks, the male departs, leaving the female all the work. She stays and cares for her chick for another 9 months, even after it's able to fly. It's the longest period of parental care of all birds. If the young one is ready, it will follow their parents into the sky, already perfectly adapted to their aerial way of life. A mere 32 kilometers from this colony, there's one island that offers no welcome to the frigatebirds, and with good reason. The island is home to around 2,000 golden lancehead pit vipers, one of the world's most venomous snakes. Check out our playlist and take a closer look.